Hi, my name is Steve Wall with Agilent Technologies. Today I'd like to introduce you to the 4100 MP-AES Microwave Plasma Atomic Emission Spectrometer. This is the first commercially available microwave plasma system on the market. It runs on air using a nitrogen generator. It offers superior performance as compared to flame atomic absorption. It has very low cost of ownership, has improved safety considerations, and also is very easy to operate. Before we take a closer look at these highlights, let's talk more about the microwave plasma technique and look at some of the internal components of the 4100. Inside the 4100, there are a couple of components that are primary to the technology of the microwave plasma. These include the magnetron and the waveguide. An industrial magnetron is used, creates electromagnetic energy at 2.5 gigahertz. This microwave energy that's created by the magnetron is then transferred to the waveguide assembly. The waveguide assembly focuses the microwave energy created in axial magnetic and radial electrical fields. By focusing and containing the microwave energy around the torch, a plasma can then be created. It's notable that the axial magnetic field is used to form the plasma, as this creates a toroidal or hollow base-shaped plasma for easy sample aerosol injection. So as mentioned, the microwave plasma system runs on air passing through a nitrogen generator. This is the Agilent 4107 nitrogen generator. It eliminates ongoing gas costs and supplies an endless supply of nitrogen. It also helps with laboratory safety as flammable gases are eliminated as well as compressed gas cylinders. This also allows us to do unattended and overnight analysis. Using this nitrogen, a plasma is formed in a conventional torch. This plasma is a high temperature excitation source, which is ideal for sample atomization and excitation, producing high intensity emission lines. Taking a closer look at the torch, we can see the sample aerosol going into the plasma, where the aerosol is dried, decomposed, and then atomized. As the atoms return to lower energy states, they emit light at characteristic wavelengths for each element. These wavelengths of light then enter the optical system using the axial view of the vertical mounted torch. This allows for best sensitivity as well as matrix tolerance. The fast scanning monochromator then transmits the selected wavelength range onto the solid state CCD detector, where spectra and background are measured simultaneously for best precision. It should be noted that no water chiller or recirculator is required to operate the 4100. As mentioned earlier, the 4100 MP-AES provides improved performance as compared to flame atomic absorption. In this example, we can see a detection limit comparison between microwave plasma and flame atomic absorption. In all cases, the microwave plasma detection limits are better than flame atomic absorption. When comparing performance of microwave plasma and flame atomic absorption, we can also look at the working range of the instrument. The working range of the microwave plasma is superior to flame atomic absorption. A typical atomic absorption calibration range for gold may be up to 40 ppm. We can easily achieve this on the microwave plasma with excellent linearity, as shown in the graph on the upper left-hand side of the screen. In fact, the working range can be extended by an additional order of magnitude, as shown on the graph in the bottom right, by using the rational polynomial curve fit. Now let's take a closer look at the sample introduction system on the 4100. The sample introduction system consists of the peristaltic pump, which is used to pump the sample up to the instrument and also to pump the drain to waste. It also consists of a spray chamber, a nebulizer, and a torch. To get to the torch, we simply unclip the spray chamber nebulizer, open the torch loader, and remove the torch. To replace the torch, you reinsert it into the torch loader and close the handle. The torch is automatically aligned, and all the gas connections are automatically connected just by closing the torch loader handle. To replace the spray chamber nebulizer, we simply clip that back on, and you're ready for analysis. In this setup, we're using a glass cyclonic spray chamber and a conventional glass nebulizer. What we can do is we can disconnect the nebulizer and we can put on a different nebulizer. This is the one neb nebulizer. This is becoming a very popular nebulizer. It uses flow blurring technology. And the unique thing about this is that the capillary tube, the internal diameter of the capillary tube, is the same all the way up to the tip of the nebulizer. With this nebulizer, we can do things like run hydrofluoric acid samples, we can run high dissolved solid samples, we can run organics, and we can even run at micro flow rates, less than 100 microliters per minute, up to greater than 2 mils per minute. So we can really see that this is a universal type nebulizer that can be useful across a great number of applications. So next we would connect the nebulizer gas connection, then connect this to the pump tubing, and we'd be ready to run. Now we've turned on instrument power, we're ready to light the plasma. To light the plasma, just come up to the menu bar and click on the plasma icon. While the plasma is initiating, we can click on the instrument status from the menu bar. Here we can check the status of the different instrument components. We can see that everything's ready to go, the plasma's on, and we're ready to run samples. Now that sample analysis is complete, we can take a closer look at the results. On the analysis tab of the software, we can see four distinct windows. The first window is the results matrix. This is where we can see our standard concentrations as well as our sample results if we scroll down a little further here. For this particular worksheet, we collected data for gold at two different wavelengths. Remember, with the MP, you can collect as many wavelengths as you want. The window on the top right of the software screen shows our spectra. Here we see the spectra for gold at 267 nanometers. And the background that we use here is something that's called auto background correction. The majority of our MP users use this unique background correction because no user interaction is required, no user selected background points need to be set, and the software automatically corrects for every sample for every wavelength automatically. No user defined points are required. So here we can see the dotted line, which represents the background, which was automatically set using auto background correction. Some additional background types can also be used, including FLIC. And FLIC stands for Fast Linear Interferent Correction. This is a spectral deconvolution technique that can be used to correct for spectral interferences at the analyte peak of interest. And of course, if you would like to select your own background position points, you can select them manually using off-peak left, off-peak right, or off-peak left and right background correction. Jumping back to the analysis tab, on the bottom right, we can see the calibration curve. In the bottom left window shows our concentration replicates, percent RSDs, and also our intensity replicates with the percent RSDs. It should be mentioned that there are a number of retrospective editing options as well. For example, if we want to retrospectively edit replicates, we could hide or edit out this replicate, and the calculation is automatically updated. Other retrospective features include changing sample labels, changing weight and volumes, additionally changing curve fits. One other feature of the software that we'd like to talk about is the applets. The 4100 can be run using applets. An applet is an icon-driven, predefined, application-specific method. When using applets, there are three easy steps for analysis. Step one is to click on the applet icon of interest. Step number two will be to go to the Sequence tab, enter the solution labels, also enter weight, volume, and dilution factors if required, then go to the Analysis page, load the samples, and click on Run. Applets, the ultimate in simplicity. The SPS3 autosampler is a random access autosampler that can be used to automate the analysis. Autosampler can be loaded up with standards and samples. Between every standard and every sample, the autosampler can be sent to the rinse through vessel to make sure there's no sample carryover between samples. There's an integrated peristaltic pump as well to pump rinse through the rinse vessel. Here we can see the autosampler is moving from standard to standard with a couple different rack sizes. This will allow you to do unattended overnight analysis. This is the multi-mode sample introduction system, also known as the MSIS. The MSIS can be used in place of the standard spray chamber. The multi-mode sample introduction system allows for detection of hydride-forming elements, including arsenic, selenium, and mercury, at single-digit to sub-ppb detection levels. As we can see, we're still also using a conventional nebulizer, which allows us to also detect the non-hydride elements at the same time as we're detecting the hydride elements. So the sample is being pumped in through here, through the conventional nebulizer. It's also being pumped in through the bottom, up through the base of this frosted glass post. The reductant is then pumped in through the top, and that's how we do the vapor generation and conventional nebulization in the MSIS. So this accessory could be useful for people who are looking for low levels of arsenic, selenium, mercury, including applications such as environmental, Wee Roche, or wastewater type applications. So here I have the external gas control module, or the EGCM. This is typically mounted on the back of the instrument, but this is what it looks like. It's used for applications such as wear metals, looking for additives and lubricants, looking at diesel fuel, even gasoline. We'd also use this if we were looking for food oils. Anytime organic solvents are used, we want to inject air through the auxiliary gas of the plasma so that we prevent carbon buildup in the torch. By injecting air, this also helps reduce the background associated with organic solvents. This is controlled automatically through the software. So hopefully I've been able to show you some of the features of the 4100 MP-AES, including the fact that it runs on air using a nitrogen generator, which means no ongoing gas costs, no compressed cylinders, no explosive gases in your laboratory, and also that we can achieve excellent performance as compared to flame atomic absorption in terms of detection limits, linear range, the fact that we can do multi-element analysis, and that we have relatively low sample consumption. Additionally, it is, hopefully as you've seen, quite easy to use and very straightforward, and hopefully will work well for your application in your laboratory. Thank you.